welcome to our animation warm-up. In this video, I'll show you how to make what I like to call roll and flip animations. These are fun and easy to make and are a great way to practice the basics of animation. For this activity, you will need some blank paper, a pencil, and scissors. You're welcome to work along with me. Just remember you can always pause, rewind, or replay this video at any time. Here's an example of a roll and flip animation I made earlier. Two slightly different pictures are drawn on a folded strip of paper. One picture is on the bottom, or inside page. The other picture is on the top, or outside page. On their own, these drawings don't actually move. But just like the name roll and flip implies, you simply roll and flip. When we flip back and forth between the two drawings fast enough, they seem to come alive. Animation is often referred to as the illusion of movement. Let's make some roll and flip animations together. Start by folding a blank piece of paper in half, lengthwise, like a hot dog bun. Holding along the folded edge, cut the paper in half. Then cut both of these pieces in half, so that you're left with four folded strips of paper. For our first roll and flip, let's practice something called squash and stretch. Squash and stretch is a great way to add life to your animations by exaggerating shape changes. Open one of your paper strips, turning the top page upwards. Roll and flips work best if we leave some blank space above and below our drawings for when we flip with our pencil. Draw a horizontal line to represent the ground. Next, draw an oval shape squashing down on the line. Imagine this oval is like a ball hitting the ground and getting ready to bounce back up, or like an animal preparing to jump. When you're ready, close the page to continue. I can faintly see my first drawing through the paper, which will be helpful for the next steps. If you've drawn too lightly, reopen the page and try darkening your lines a little. You can also hold your paper up to a well-lit window. On the outside page, draw a copy of the ground line as close to the same size and position as the first. This will help keep the ground from moving when we watch our animations. But this time, let's stretch the oval vertically in the air, directly above its original position, as if the ball is bouncing straight up or the animal is jumping. When you're ready to test your animation, roll the top page nice and tight around your pencil to create a strong springy coil. Re-roll and tighten as needed. Hold down along the fold with one hand, then using your pencil, give it a flip. See the squash and stretch? Here's a similar example without squash and stretch. Notice how the first animation feels flexible and elastic, while the second animation looks more rigid and stiff. Remember, animation is the illusion of movement. To help create this illusion, whatever you animate should maintain the same volume between drawings, even if they squash and stretch. You may have noticed that roll and flip animations have no beginning or end. Animations that repeat the same action over and over are called cycles. With roll and flips, we can animate cycles that move up and down, side to side, grow and shrink, even open and close. Practice animating different cycles on your own. Start with basic shapes and lines, then gradually add details. The animations shown here are just examples. Have fun using your own creativity and imagination. In fact, I'd love to see any you create. Bye for now and have fun animating. Special thanks to the Ontario Arts Council and DSBN's Outdoor Education for supporting this video series.